In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to easily mask your canopies inside and out. Watch the video until the end because I will give you some top tips along the way. What is up, fellas? Today we are going to do some masking. And just wait to see how our job will compare to pre-cut masks. So, let's start off with some masking tape on the cutting mat. We have two options to choose from. The first option is an almost thin strip of masking tape. The wider the tape, it's easier to hold a straight line. So this is suitable for canopies where we have mostly flat frames with straight edges. Top tip number 1. Cut the end of the tape at an acute angle. This way you'll be able to position it in the corner without overlapping the frame. After you place the tape on the canopy, maneuver it gently into position. When it comes to cutting the excess, be very careful. Apart from scratching the clear part, you can crack the canopy if too much pressure is applied. I recommend a fresh blade and just pay attention. Also, try to use scissors where it is possible. Now, some may say this is too much time consuming and why don't you use pre-cut masks? First of all, speed rarely achieves quality in my opinion. And yes, masks are awesome most of the time, but in some cases they just fail. I will show you a comparison later in the video. Our second option is to cut a really narrow strip of masking tape. In this way we can follow all sorts of curves. The narrower the strip is, it can handle tighter corners. You'll see an example in a few seconds. One thing I forgot to show you is a cool tool, a flathead stick. It will help you adjust the tape with far less risks for the clear part. Now you can see we have a beveled corner in the bottom. And all we have to do is bend the tape and burnish it down with a stick. Alright, the exterior is done, let's do the interior. It's almost the same procedure, only you have the benefit of following the exterior masks as a guide. Surprisingly, masking the interior of the canopy seems to be a controversial topic. I personally feel that it's necessary, especially in 1:48 and larger scales. Here's what we have so far, almost perfect. Unlike the pre-cut masks, which just can't cope with the compound surface. Top tip number 2. Bend a piece of tape and spread the ends apart. Then stick it on the transparent surface and you have somewhere to hold the canopy for painting. As you have noticed, all we have so far are frames. To fill the rest, I'm using liquid mask. So get some kind of applicator and carefully apply the liquid. Here are a few cool things about using masking liquid. In conjunction with the tape, we take advantage of capillarity. Where capillarity is the ability of liquid to flow through narrow spaces without the assistance of or even in opposition to external forces like gravity. Another advantage is that if you mess up, you can just remove the liquid after it's dry and try again. Some masking liquids can be cut. It's relatively fast to apply. And probably something else that I forget right now. Okay, now let's quickly apply the interior color both on the inside and the outside. Before applying the exterior color, I mask the inside of the canopy using tape, but only on the edges. Then I put some sponge inside so it protects the rest and gives me a sturdier place to handle the detail. The problem with using only sponge is that you can get some unwanted chipping effect, which can become three-dimensional if you leave the paint to dry. Now let's quickly apply the exterior color. Make sure you give your final coat enough time to set because you can rub it off when you remove the masking. Now it's time for the most satisfying part of the process, removing the masks. First, you have to pick the edge of the tape with your blade. Then, using tweezers, lift the tape so it doesn't stick again. If you're using gloves like I do, it's very easy to remove most of the liquid mask. Once the tape is mostly free, it's easily removed with tweezers. It's mostly the same deal for the interior, but if you can't stick your finger inside, you can use tweezers to remove the bulk of the masking liquid. Just be careful not to scratch the surface. Sometimes you can remove the entire masking with hands only. Easy. In my opinion, this technique is quite easy and with some experience it can be done quite fast. This canopy took me no more than 2 hours with the painting, so that's not bad at all considering the result. Now go ahead and watch more of my tutorials. You'll have good time, I promise. Thanks for watching and until next time, happy modeling!